Hello, let us learn the curd seller. Masti Venkatesha Iyengar was a renowned writer in Kannada language. He was honored with the Gnanpeeth Award, so which is the highest literary honor conferred in India. So Iyengar was popularly referred to as Masti Kannadada Asti, which means Masti Kannada's treasure. He is well known for his short stories. He wrote under the pen name Srinivasa. Masti Venkatesha Iyengar's The Curd Seller effectively demonstrates the politics of day-to-day life in the most simple homes and a struggle for power. This short story is all about a middle-aged, uneducated, innocent woman who sells curd for a living. The curd, a commodity, it has a limited shelf life. The culture of making curds, the storing, preparing and distributing requires a special skill of expertise. The story, Curd Seller, setting is in the outskirts of Bangalore, where there are homes which buy curds from the pot that the curd seller brings it in. The texture and the quality of the product and its regular delivery ensure the regular business and a loyal clientele. The challenges posed by the weather in transporting and delivering the fresh product can only or managed by a smart, efficient seller, which Mangamma has proved to be. Buying and selling in small town villages merely depend on the relationships that thrive on trust and confidence. Mangamma's interaction is restricted to the lady of the house, who also develops a kind of relationship because of their everyday conversations. It is common to talk about the little joys and challenges of their respective homes if time, weather and occasion are conducive for an informal discussion. Amidst their interaction, Mangamma gives an advice to the lady of the house, blurs the invisible social barrier that exists between the two classes, poor and the rich. A naive Mangamma gives tips to the lady of the house on safeguarding her marriage by exercising how to control the husband. In our view, an attractive appearance and a little saving for the rainy day are the secret ingredients to a successful marriage. Her worldly knowledge amuses the lady of the house and she becomes her close friend. Mangamma's identity is defined by the commodity she sells, which is the curd. So she is popular as the curd seller. And the social relations she maintains with the people whom she interacts on an everyday basis. Mangamma and her daughter-in-law have a row over disciplining their little grandson in the family. One argument leads to another and Mangamma is forced to live independently alone. The independent, empowered Mangamma is distraught with the sudden twist of events in her otherwise predictable routine. On second thoughts, a rational Mangamma decides to love herself and spend on her clothes to dress modestly as she doesn't feel the need to save money anymore. She decides to splurge a little and pamper herself. She even confronts a city boy who marks her fondness for expensive clothes as she wears one of those mukmul blouses. She has a mind of her own and she confidently defies convention to wear nice expensive clothes and be presentable and give herself the comfort of soft linen. An uneducated single woman in a village separated from her husband does not think twice
to assert herself. She even confronts her son and daughter-in-law on her choice of fabric and doesn't feel threatened by their comments. The social construction doesn't allow the woman to handle for finances without the support of a male member in the family. This is evident when an otherwise confident, straightforward, worldly wise Mangamma is intimidated by the advances of Rangappa after she is separated from her son. She realizes the need to secure the earnings with her trusted friend, the lady of the house. The lady from the higher social order comes across as a timid woman who cannot take a stand to help out Mangamma by keeping her earrings with her. She gives an evasive reply and says she needs her husband's permission. She comes across as a less empowered woman who is economically comfortable but selects to be the subversant gender by using her husband, the powerful and decision-making individual of the house, as an alibi for her conveniences. She is content with her identity as the powerless lady of the house who is unwilling to help her rise up to the occasion. The empowered, financially independent, yet a very emotional Mangamma is reluctant to break ties with the loving son, daughter-in-law, and grandson. She is staggered with Rangappa's advances towards her when she starts living alone. She realizes the physical strength of her male counterpart is certainly overpowering. She is smart enough to make peace, but her ego will not let her make the first move. The struggle for power by the two women in the family is evident. They are all out to prove their mettle. Mangamma's equally sensible, stalwart daughter-in-law, Nanjamma, hatches a plan to take control of the situation by instructing her young son to be around Mangamma. Mangamma is proud that grandson has chosen to live with her and decides to soften her stand for her son and daughter-in-law. Mangamma welcomes the grandson who she thinks is a good substitute for the absence of any male member in her life. The established pattern in the society invariably thrusts the idea of a male being a sense of security and power for the women, irrespective of age and physical strength. The reconciliation happens in a subtle way, with the control of finances and domestic chores being shared by the two women. Mangamma exchanges her profitable curd-selling business for the control that she can establish in the management at home and live a secure life with love and respect. A happy Nanjamma takes over the established profitable business and makes peace with her mother-in-law, Mangamma. The struggle for power is evident in every society, irrespective of the social order they represent. The Mangamma. Thank you for watching. Subscribe. Communication Skills for Everyone.